Tell me about the slick screw. I understand that you were the surgeon designer.
The slick screw is pretty slick. Basically what it's designed for is when you tear the ligaments in the wrist, you need to repair these. And then after they're repaired, you have to hold that repair for a prolonged period of time as the ligaments heal. And because the ligaments are inside the joint, there's a lot of fluid, and that can help delay or slow the healing process. So traditionally, after you fix the ligaments, you put some wires in to support your repair. And these wires either are beneath the skin or stick out of the skin, but they only can be left in so long, about 6 to 8 weeks, before you have to pull them out because you're concerned of infection. But probably the ligament takes longer to heal than 6 to 8 weeks. And so this was the whole idea of the slick screw, because you generally could put a screw across, but because the normal bones have some motion between them, then that screw can loosen. So the whole idea with the slick screw is, let's make a screw that actually toggles or swivels in the middle. So this screw fully rotates and has about 20 degrees of toggle built into it. And so what this does is, after you fix the ligaments, you put the screw in, and then all the motion theory goes within the screw itself, and that decreases the chance of the screw loosening in the bones. So you can leave this device in for 6 to 9 months while the ligaments heal, and then take it out if the patient desires. So I think it's a big advantage to what's previously been out there, that we can hold the ligaments for a prolonged period of time and let them heal. We've done these in a number of athletic people, allowed them to play sports with the screw in, then take the screw out later. I've not seen any difficulty with that.